Hey internet, let's take a trip down the memory lane of MSI DPU industrial design. Hey internet, Gordon Ng with PCWorld here. We're coming to you from MSI's headquarters in Taipei, Taiwan, with a rare look at the history of MSI's GPU industrial design. I know that doesn't sound like a big deal to you. It's just something that pops out on the shelf, goes into your system, and you don't think about it. But let me tell you, after talking to the industrial design team and looking at all of these GPUs, there's a lot more to it. Let's start our journey at the beginning, 15 years ago, with the original MSI N260GTX Lightning. Of course, that means a GeForce 260, and for new people, the GTX actually used to go after the model number, but this was the original MSI card with the Twin Frozr cooling. And of course, it was a big deal because you get your two fans, but also this fan shroud is actually aluminum. The reason I was told is, you know, there was some internal discussions at the time, and if you're paying a lot for a cool graphics card to play your games, they wanted to give you a feel of quality, and nothing says quality like aluminum. And that's why you ended up with a metal shroud on this card. This card actually goes all the way back to 2008. But let's keep going because it gets cooler from there. This is the next Frozr card. You still get your two fans. You get your aluminum shroud because that's basically what the style was to give you quality. So you can see it's called Twin Frozr. This same design was basically used in the 400 series and 500 series of GeForce cards. It did get, of course, this is the lower end version. You also got a smaller version, you know, for the lower end cards. And of course, because you're not paying the money for a higher end card, that aluminum shroud, you're not gonna get here. This is pretty much plastic, as you can see, because this is used on most entry-level graphics cards back in the day. Let's move on to the next version. We got the Twin Frozr 3 used in the 500 series and 600 series of NVIDIA cards. And again, you're still getting Twin Frozr, and also you're gonna see a little bit of a change. The fan prop has been changed a little bit. They said they wanted to give it an airplane propeller-like feel, and also it looks like there's a different texture. Probably that's that like fight between the industrial designers and also the engineers that want to have that cutout here, but I guess they wanted to have that to make it look a little cooler. They actually had several different designs in this era, so this one's still similar. And look, you're still getting the aluminum shroud because that was the quality back then, you know, 10 years ago or so. Here's another one where we actually got a translucent shroud. It's still giving you aluminum, but you got a little bit of red in here. I'm guessing this might have been used in a Radeon card. And then check this out, here is another one. Still getting aluminum shroud, blue fans. But that was the, for use again, for the 500 and 600 series of GeForce cards. Let's click it up a notch. It's interesting to me also that at this point, MSI was basically using the same shrouds for a couple generations. We saw in the last two where they were used for two generations. We see that again here with this series of MSI GPUs, where this same industrial design was used for the 600 and 700 series of cards.
And this one has black and red.
It has black and red. That's actually the, you know, again, when you're talking about design, you're talking very much about PC gamer fashion. And back in the day, this is when black and red really kind of started to show up, because you couldn't just have silver, which didn't say gamer. If you were a gamer back then, you had to have black and red, and you're seeing that in this generation of card. They actually had quite a few different variations as well. This one's gonna give you this nice copper. It's not actually metal though, but it gives you a nice copper feel, but you are getting, of course, your copper heat stack, fin stack on the GPU. And look at this one. These things will bring back some memories for some people. You're still getting that two-tone fan. This one, I'm gonna guess, is the little lower-end GPU that it was used for, because basically you didn't get all the copper stack. Now let's move up. As we move from the 600 and 700 series of GeForce cards, And someone check Wikipedia, because Gordon's probably wrong. Was there an 800 series? There was no 800 series. Maybe Gordon is actually right. So in the 900 series of GeForce cards, we still see that red and black look. But I'm going to show you something that is different here. And I did not realize that until I did this tour here. These little red lines that showed up with the 900 series of MSI GPUs, that was actually the first time that they started to try to use some of the ID from the MSI Dragon. Because look, this is the first time we're seeing the MSI Dragon. And the concept was that Dragon's Claw, I guess delivering your GPU to your system, leaves a mark on the card, and that's what these little red cutouts on the GPU represented here, the claw marks. And look, let's check out a couple other interesting ones here. Look at this one. Gold and black. And also this one. You're still getting your claw marks, but it was green and black. I'm guessing probably for a GeForce card for the green. All right, let's tick it up one more generation here. Let's go to the 10 series. So you're seeing again the 10 series of MSI GPU. We're still seeing the claw marks. You're actually seeing a little more texture here too. So the idea of the texture on these GPUs at this time was dragons have dragon scale. They have dragon skin, tough as nails. And they basically added an ID to the card to sort of simulate the dragon scales on the GPU. Because again, that was very much leaning into the dragon motif that MSI's started to really push heavily in this vintage. With this generation of card, MSI actually started implementing not RGB, because back in this day, you were not really getting RGB, but you basically got LED backlighting for these dragon claw marks on the GPU. This one's actually also kind of cool because it's a good example for the internal decisions of a company and the tensions between the art team and the business people, because this is the final card you're seeing here. But MSI actually has some of the mock-ups for this card that are pretty cool to look at. So we actually have this mock-up. So this is one of the design that actually didn't make it. There's a couple things you could see. There's just, you got a lot more clear translucent plastic in here. That didn't make the cut. Here's another one. This didn't make the cut either. You sort of see they're playing with the industrial design on the card. You got the dragon skin, you got the claw marks. This one actually was the attempt to, well, could we integrate, LED lighting along the perimeter of this? Didn't make the cut either. Again, you still have the claw marks. We didn't have all the patterns here. But the reason why this is interesting to me is there's some decisions that go into this, like this one and this one. Both of these designs didn't make the cut in the final card. And that is, of course, because the art team wants to implement art. The business team wants to make money. And you check out this one feature here that sort of says it. This, you can see on the final production card, there's no screws. Originally, this actually had a screw together construction. Somebody has to screw these things together when you're building them. That means more time to make these cards. I'm gonna guess that basically somebody says, you know what, I ain't paying somebody to make this shroud and sit there and screw every single one together. So let's go to this one that's possibly glued together or injected bolted together. And again, this, you're the art team, you wanna do something really cool. And then your business manager says that's gonna cost us money and we're not gonna do it. And you end up with the product that in the end is what you get, because, again, these products have to make money, and somebody decided, let's make more money than to do your vision. That's the way it is. Let me tell you, I tell my boss that all the time. With the 10 series, of course, we got more powerful cards, and for that, you need more cooling, and you can see MSI basically puts great big gigantic cooling on this card, which, of course, sees the first introduction of a large three-fan design from them. You're also going to see something I've seen only old timers remember is PC fashion changing. Because remember, we went from just basically silver to red and black. Now you can see that the red and black thing is kind of starting to fade out. There was a time when you could still wear bell-bottom pants and people weren't making fun of you. Well, you know what? We're at to the point where the red and black thing is starting to play itself out. There's a little bit of red here. But check this out. By the time we get to the 20 series, there's barely any red on this fan because, again, PC fashion changes. Suddenly gamers said, I don't want to see red and black. I want all black because that's cool. The other thing that we'll also see is you get the dragon scale here, but the claw marks that have been on MSI cards for about three generations is now gone because, as I understand it, somebody said, like, you know what? We think the claw marks thing is played out, so get rid of them. And instead of the claw marks, the idea with the industrial design on this generation of cards, this is the two-fan one, here's a three-fan one, is actually the armor. So you sort of see this, like, bulked up pieces of armor that a dragon might have on it if it were wearing armor. And that's kind of what the design ID is trying to show you. Of course, we're seeing far more advanced lighting. This, I'm gonna guess, is RGB from the looks of it. Okay, let's move from 20 series to 30 series. And well, we saw just a little tiny splash of red on the previous version. It's all gone now. So again, a lot of this is PC fashion. There's no more red on this card. It's basically all black here and silver. You also see the fan design has changed a little bit. This is mostly functional. This is not necessarily an industrial design thing. It's the impeller has been changed to basically probably help improve the acoustics on the card. So it's enclosed on some of the blades, but it's an all black and silver card. So in addition to the armor, of course, remember that time your boss told you to get rid of that thing and then they came back 2 days later and told you to bring it back? Yeah, it's not their fault, it's your fault. And you see actually, apparently in the previous version where they wanted no claw marks, they actually wanted the claw marks back in this generation of cards. So add the claw marks back and you can see it here. I don't know if these are lit up or not. I think they might be on this card in RGB, but it's just funny to me. It's the classic boss thing where, hey, get rid of that, but actually do the opposite of what I just told you 2 days ago. So let's move from 30 series to 40 series. Of course, this is the current iteration of these graphics cards. It is definitely much larger than the 30 series, of course. We actually see now the texture coming back a little bit. We see the dragon scale here a little bit, it looks to me. We actually, again, also see the claw marks. And of course, it is one big gigantic card. We probably RGB here. And it is one huge card. This, of course, is all of MSI's gaming cards. There's a couple more we're going to take a look at. A little bit different because, you know, this is designed to appeal to gamers. We look at here, you know, for most normal people, this is MSI's Ventus lineup. It's basically a little more mainstream. It's not as aggressive. It might go into some machines that might even go into a small office or corporate office where they need a GPU, but don't want all the gaming MOTIF. So you can see the drastic difference between all the Dragon on all the gaming stuff. This looks like a pretty plain Jane GPU because I think that is the idea with the Ventus lineup because look, they look pretty normal. You know, and actually for some people, this is what they would prefer. And there's no dragon scales. There's no claw marks. It's just good old GPU inside. So starting with the 30 series, MSI actually wanted to offer a higher end graphics card version. This is actually the Suprim card. Got even more heat pipes, more fin stacks. And you do get the MSI Dragon on here, but it's fairly understated. You get a little bit of the shape of the armor, but not going overboard with the gamer motif.
You get chamfered edges. It's supposed to be like a real high-end luxury item.
Yeah, and you know, again, this is a premium card, so you're actually getting a little bit of gold because rich people like gold. We know this. I know this to be true. And look, this is the 40 series version of the Suprim. I can barely lift it up, but this looks like a premium card. Only one fan gets a dragon, the others don't. So again, the whole dragon thing is not overly stated, but it is a premium card. You're still getting the little gold highlights, but not the all out kind of crazy kind of gamer kind of focus on there. There's actually a couple more we're gonna close off with. And you know, speaking of understated, let's check out the Evoke series. Now these cards are actually made to basically look like premium cards. And they're all gold and black. And again, there's no dragon on here except for the logo up here, but it's designed to be more understated, but still give you all that performance. And then this actually is really pretty cool. MSI has had a Lightning card for a while. It's basically a limited edition card. 500 to 1,000 are made. You've got the Lightnings on the fan hubs. You've got these two-tone fans. And believe me, that costs more money to make.
Dual injection molded. Yeah,
dual injection molded. So you have to be able to get, the design team has to go and argue with the business team as to why they want to pay the extra money for that. Again, this is a limited edition card, and you can see it's actually got carbon fiber. And I don't mean that cheap cover that somebody puts on their car. This is actually carbon fiber on this car because this is a very high-end limited edition card, and I want to show you this last. And the last really cool feature on the card is it actually has a small OLED integrated into the top of the card. So it is the Lightning version, and that is the limited edition version that MSI does on occasion. So pretty cool. So in talking to MSI, there's a ton of decisions and thought processes that goes into making and designing these cards. There's working with the engineers, there's working with the business people, and you're still trying to get your vision of what you think gamers want on their cards. So the next time you buy your GPU and you dig the way it looks, think about all the hard work these people have put into that card to make it for you.